All right, man. Today, we gonna talk about Nest and DNA. I know I've been late on everything, man. And the reason is I haven't been inspired by most of the battles, man. I'm personally feeling a little let down from Summer Madness. I almost could have did without it so far. The John joint was, you know, that was a cool battle. And, you know, I appreciated the lesson that Lux gave Calico. Outside of that, I'm feeling kind of, you know, indifferent towards Summer Madness so far. A lot of letdown, a lot of hype for nothing at all. So I want to jump right into the letdown number two. You know, the Mook joint was a ridiculous letdown. Like, you heard the hype and then you saw what happened. Nah. But this dude, DNA. Because what I heard what you heard. Everybody heard the same thing. Everybody heard, oh, he body bagged Ness. He body bagged Ness. We going to talk about this body bag thing, too. But that's another blog that probably be coming up tomorrow. But for right now, let's be clear. He did not body bag Ness. You understand? Hold up. Because I know y'all talking now. Hold up. He won, but he did not body bag. He was trash. You understand me? He was trash. DNA, to be clear, DNA was trash. Right? He was better than Ness. Yes. But he was trash. On the 1 to 10, Ness was a 2. Maybe 3. My man was not a 5. You understand what I'm talking about? He wasn't proven grounds worthy. Not proven grounds worthy. You understand? Trash. Like, it was so much trash. Like, I'm gonna say this though. One part of the battle was really exciting though. He the end of the first joint, he got a little hype, you know. I forgot exactly what he said, but he got hype. He had the crowd involved, and it was cool, you know. I was like, okay, you know, maybe he came to play. No. Homie was trash, B. The humorous part of this battle, what made this battle worth watching, and the replay, oh man, pardon me. The replay value is crazy if you watch it for the humor. You know, not watching it for no bars, because there were none the whole battle. There was no bars. My man said, he asked Ness something, like, who you shot, who you stabbed, Ness. Ness told that nigga, plenty niggas, you know, plenty. Like, you know, Ness is a crazy looking dude anyway, so Ness got this look on his face, like, you know, plenty niggas. So it was wild, like, I don't know, me. Like, I'm easily amused, so I was very, very tickled by that, right? And things of that nature happened, like, you know, 4 or 5 times, like, in a major way throughout the battle. My man was extra, extra disrespectful, like, Listen, whoa. He disrespected Smack Terrible. I'm talking about Ness now. He disrespected Smack Terrible. You know, basically, yeah, you know. Smack is starting to turn into Murder Mook. You remember Mook used to get it every battle, somebody would just come and just disrespect Mook on stage? That's Smack now. Smack didn't got disrespected in the last, you know, 10 battles, like 6 times. It's looking rough. He's starting to be the sideline punching bag, you know. Smack better tighten up, you know? But, what else happened? My man was just snapping the whole time, Ness. Just snapping, cutting this nigga off, disrespecting him, won't let him rap. Niggas looking around like, help me. They looking at Smack for help. And I'm talking about Charlie Clips. He trying to defend his young son, and he in the background. He nudging him like, come on, DNA, go. He jumping in the front, and like, Smack, tell him stop, Smack. It was looking real crazy out there. Ness got very disrespectful. So I salute Ness just for speaking his mind, you know what I mean? Because it was biased. It was definitely biased. It was biased because, like he said, they should have been booing my man. They should have been booing him horrible, just like they booed that dude. Both of them was trash. They both don't need to come back no time soon. And, you know, what's this? It's like October or something. I don't really want to see them dudes to St. Patrick's Day or after. You know what I mean? I don't want to see Ness ever. Let me say that. Matter of fact, let's talk about that. Let's talk about this legend thing. Return of the legends. Like, Ness a legend how? A legend to who? A legend where? You understand what I'm talking about? And I was a Ness fan back then when I seen Ness get it off on Making of the Band, him and Jay Mills. That battle was crazy. Now that was something worth talking about. Puff, You Cheesecake Funny Dude, release that battle DVD. Release that battle clear. You understand? We got all these bootleg versions. That battle was crazy. Them boys was going. What happened after that? I think Ness battled Solomon. He let Solomon put the hands on him. You know, Solomon dusted him. Then Arsenal came to Philly, and I think they recorded the joint with camera phones or something. It was the worst ever, so it was trash. I think Arsenal dusted him. That was crazy. So now he's here, and we're talking about Return of the Legend. You know, maybe I missed something. Maybe one of you battle heads out there can, you know, fill me in on where the legend thing happened, but I ain't seen it, you know? Homie's not a legend. Homie shouldn't be invited back to nobody's arena, nowhere. And with that said, nah, we not even off Ness. We not even, I was about to say we off Ness, but we not off Ness. Ness was snapping, right? Ness, dudes had said that Ness threw the water around, but that ain't really what happened. Ness was just snapping, and they hit hands, and the water flew up in the air, so he just, you know, he let it go. But he really won't that disrespect. He didn't throw the water around crazy like that. But it was funny, he disrespect, I believe it was Charlie Cortez, DNA, and I want to say Math. I'm pretty sure he said Math name. But he was like, yo, y'all niggas is corny. All y'all niggas, this won't rap. This was real feeling, like, he won't playing, you know. All that, you know, that tough guy persona of everybody, like, no, nobody was tough. But Ness, like, you know, Ness was very irate with these dudes, right? It was hilarious. I mean, I could ramble on and on, but you gotta see it. It's like four parts of the battle, man, that's really worth watching. Just the humor factor, the utter disrespect that was shown, man. Whoa, it was crazy. Can't stress enough, though. DNA, I don't want to see you no more, homeboy. Holler at me next summer. Definitely not Summer Madness. I don't know, give him a spring card somewhere, you know. DNA is one of them dudes that, you want to like him because he's the underdog and he tries so hard. And, you know, we appreciate what DNA, you know, try to do. But DNA really ain't, he's not nobody you take serious. You know, I hate the corny phrase swag, you know, but the nigga swags off, you know. He has no presence, he has no charisma, he has no believability. He can be lyrical, you know, but it's just like, man, I don't want to see that. I don't want to hear that. Like, you know, I don't want to believe you. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, man. I ain't trying to disrespect DNA, man, but I just don't feel him. I mean, I don't feel him. I don't feel him. Nope, I don't feel him. I tried to, like, think about it, like, him and the disaster thing. Thought about it. He's pretty good. I personally don't like him. I personally don't want to see him no more. Let me fast forward to Ness being disrespectful again. Please watch it just to see that, you know. The video got crazy thumbs down, like the Mook battle. It's awful. I want to talk about Top Tier too in the next video, because, you know, I was just about to say that legend thing, and then my man, DNA. It's crazy, like, all this top tier, bottom tier, everybody's top tier. We gotta talk about that. I need some clarity on what's top tier and what makes niggas hot. And we gotta talk about that. But we gonna jump into that next video. Brother Abdul, out. Hey, I forgot. It was one thing that Smack was doing and I was not feeling. First of all, he was looking like a sucker. That's number one. But besides him looking like a sucker, Smack was actually trying to calm the crowd down. Now, I appreciate him doing that because the crowd gets ridiculous, right? This shouldn't be happening. Like, you know, they just go too overboard. But I've seen Smack stand back and let other niggas have it. Like, he ain't trying to calm nobody down. You know, Verb is one. Verb is the number one. Like, they be giving Verb the business. Like, it's crazy for no reason. Like, I don't get it. But bottom line is, I'm feeling like Smack is showing a little bias when you want to jump in and try to, you know, calm the crowd down for some niggas, and then you let the crowd just have their way with other niggas. I think that's a little crazy. I don't know. Let me know how you feel about that. I just thought that was worth mentioning, you know. Let me know if you see what I saw.
My beloved Iron Sheik say, Allah walk, Bob. I got you.